It's demo time now. We'll configure log agent in an EC2 instance, we'll create a log group, and we'll use filter patterns. Then we'll export the data to S3. I'm running this EC2 instance which has Apache running on it, basic Apache, and it has a basic web server like this. This page is being returned by this EC2 instance. Now what we'll do is we'll install CloudWatch logs agent in this EC2 instance, and then we'll push all the files generated by Apache or httpd to CloudWatch logs. This is the EC2 instance and this is the directory where Apache logs are stored. These are the two files, access_log and error_log. All access logs are sent to access_log files and all Apache errors are sent to error_log file. Before installing the CloudWatch agent and everything, let me show you how to create CloudWatch log groups, what are log streams and how do they look like. This is our CloudWatch console. Then click on logs. This is the CloudWatch logs dashboard. And the only thing which you have to create is create log group. You can give it any log group name. And this is the log group. As of now, there are no log streams. This log group has nothing in here. So log streams will typically not be created by us. It will be created by the applications or the services which are sending data or log events to this log stream or to this log group. There are multiple things which you can do on a CloudWatch log group. You can export all data from this log group to an S3 bucket. Click on export data to Amazon S3 and then you can choose a bucket from this account or from a different account, and then you can choose a bucket. All the CloudWatch logs data would be exported to the S3 bucket which you just mentioned. We can also stream it to AWS Lambda or AWS Elasticsearch Service. By default, CloudWatch log groups data are never expired. You can expire it after some time. Click on this never expire and then you can change the retention period. So it can start from 1 day till 10 years or never expire. So typically it would be, you'd want this as per your requirement. But as far as logs are concerned, they lose relevance after a certain time. Newer logs are always better. The older they become, the more they lose relevance to your application. When we install CloudWatch logs agent in this particular EC2 instance, that agent will push all data from this access log and error log file to a certain log group and then to a certain log stream. This is what access_log file contains. It contains where this particular website has been accessed from. This is our website. I am accessing it only from my machine. So it will show that it has been accessed from a Chrome browser with some IP address and Safari. Now, when you install CloudWatch logs agent, what that agent does is it creates a CloudWatch log group and it creates a CloudWatch log streams. We do not have to pre-configure the CloudWatch log groups or CloudWatch log streams because it increases a little bit of overhead and the mapping also becomes difficult. So if you allow the agent to create the log groups as and when you install agent on EC2 instances or on-premise data centers, that agent will create the log groups and log streams for you. But to do that, we have to assign a role to this EC2 instance, or we have to share the access ID key and secret access key, which is of course not a good idea. As we know how roles work, what I'll do is I'll create a role that will be a service role. In the trust policy, the principal would be ec2.amazonaws.com. And then I'll attach a permission policy to that role, which will allow that role to create CloudWatch log group and log stream. This is the permission policy. I'm allowing these actions to create log group, logs create log stream, logs put log events, and logs describe log streams. So these are the different actions which I'm allowing in this permission policy. And the resource is anyone. We'll have to give anyone because we do not know what would be the name of the log group, what would be the name of the log stream. If you have already created the log groups and log streams, you can change the resource on here. You can mention the log group and its corresponding log stream, but we'll not complicate things. I'll review this policy and create it. The policy has been created and now I'll attach this policy with a role. We already have a role created, EC2 instance profile role. I'll modify this role. In the trust relationship, everything would be same. In the principal, we have service ec2.amazonaws.com and the action is STS assume role. But in the permissions policy, along with Amazon S3 full access, I'll add one more access, or I'll attach one more policy which you have just created. So I'll attach CloudWatch logs event role policy to this particular role. The name of the role is instance profile role. Now I'll attach this role to the running EC2 instance. As of now, no role has been attached to this EC2 instance. I'll change this to EC2 instance profile role and apply. If you are running CloudWatch logs agent in an on-premise data center, so that you can send application logs running in your on-premise servers to CloudWatch logs, then you'll have to either share the secret access key and access key ID, or you'll have to create a federated ID which will have the corresponding permissions policy attached to the role. To install CloudWatch log agents, the first thing which you have to do is update all your packages. This is the command to update your packages in Amazon Linux. This EC2 instance has been launched in the default VPC, so it has internet connectivity by default. If you are running EC2 instances in private subnets, you have to make sure that a NAT gateway or a NAT instance is attached to the subnet where your EC2 instances are running, and all outbound internet traffic should go via NAT gateway. Only then you can download this AWS logs agent. This is the command to be used to install CloudWatch logs agent. I have already updated my packages and installed CloudWatch logs agent. That's why you are seeing this message. By default, the CLI file is stored here. This is the file. The default region is US East 1. If you want, you can change it wherever your CloudWatch logs are. Once that is done, you'll have to edit the configuration file. This is where the default configuration log file is stored. /etc/aws/logs/aws/logs.conf. This is the configuration file, and it has a fair amount of documentation involved. It will tell you which file, what you should mention in date time format, what should be the log stream, what is initial position, and etc. Go to the end of the file, and then here you can mention everything. This will be for where log, then access logs, and you want to monitor this file. The date time format and the file, which file you want CloudWatch agent to monitor. So this is the file which will be monitored, and the log stream name. Log stream name, you can mention AWS Foundation, will be a string, and then the instance ID. This instance ID would be taken from the instance metadata. Initial position, don't change it, keep it start of the file. And the log group name, I'll mention same as that of our file name. You'll have a one-to-one mapping between your operating system files, which your CloudWatch agent is monitoring, and your CloudWatch log group. Once that is done, you have to start the AWS logs service. Remember one thing: if the log groups and the log streams are not created, they are not present, they'll be created automatically by the CloudWatch logs agent. That's why we attached a role with this EC2 instance. In the role, you have mentioned create log group, create log stream, and put log events actions. You have allowed those things. Then you have to start the service. AWS logs agent has been started. Now this agent should put all data from Apache access logs into the CloudWatch log group. Refresh it and you will see that the log group has been created. Under that you have log stream, which is AWS Foundation and the instance ID. Under that, this is the log file which is CloudWatch is monitoring, and the data would be sent to CloudWatch every now and then. So herein you have entire data of that file. I'll create another log group for the error log. Go to the instance and edit the same file, awslogs.conf. This time it is for error log file, and the file which I want CloudWatch agent to monitor is in var log httpd error underscore log. This is the buffer duration, log stream name. I'll keep the same stream name. Initial position would also be the same, and the log group name would be error underscore log. Save this, and now CloudWatch logs agent should push all the files from error log to CloudWatch log. Now data from this error log file should be sent to CloudWatch by CloudWatch logs agent. Refresh here and the error log file has appeared. Now click on this one, it will contain only those records which you have seen. So these are the records. This is how CloudWatch logs agent works. So you install AWS logs and you start the service. You provide the configuration in awslogs.conf file, that which files you want the CloudWatch logs agent to monitor, and the logs agent will pull records from those files and push it to CloudWatch. Now, the most important part, you can create matrix filter. What is a matrix filter? We have already seen AWS matrix. Now, in this case, we are getting records from an application which is running in our EC2 instance. It could be your on-premise server also. So, CloudWatch will not have any default matrix, which you can use to create alarms and everything. So, you can create a matrix filter. Select any of the log group. I'll use access log because that has more records. Click on create matrix filter. Mention the filter pattern. Let's say get. You can test the pattern. And it'll showing you 38 matches found out of 49 events in the log file. So show test results. It'll showing you these are the records which has been selected. Now, not only that, you can mention this entire string. So I mentioned the entire string. Now it is showing only 15 matches out of 49 events. So this is only for Apache. If you want, you can monitor your database platform also. You can monitor Java application, Python application, Node.js, JavaScript, whatever you want, whatever application you are running in your EC2 instances or on-premise data centers, all those applications or database platforms for that matter generate log files. And the only thing which you have to do is install CloudWatch logs agent in the server or EC2 instance where your application or platform is running. Allow that agent to push file to CloudWatch logs. This is how you integrate your application logs with CloudWatch. Now, this filter pattern, I'll go ahead and create this one. I'll assign a metric. The metric namespace, you give it any name, log metrics, say HTTPD or Apache log metrics. I'll give it a name, get304 methods. This is the name of the metric. You can create filter. Now, as the filter has been created, you can create alarm on this particular filter, like we did using our AWS services. If you click on create alarm, it will give you the same alarm pane where you can create the alarm from. You can mention that whenever methods, the number of methods is more than 50, you should raise an alarm. If number of error messages are more than 1000, you should be notified, etc. Everything remains same as far as alarm is concerned. The only metric is changing, and this time the metric is a customized matrix. It is not provided by AWS or any of the AWS services. It is provided by an application which you are running in EC2 instance or any of your on-premise data centers. Once the metric filters are created, you can see them from this log console itself. So if you see here, you have matrix filter and it is saying that this log group has only one filter. Click on this and it will give you the same matrix filter which you just created. And you can create alarm from here as well. That's how CloudWatch logs work. It is very important. You can not only monitor your AWS services, you can monitor your applications which are running inside of EC2 instances and your on-premise data centers also. That's all for this part. Thanks for watching.